Without live video streaming, unlimited drone range is really worthless. So in this version, I'm gonna upgrade all the things I said. Let me show the features I want. Live video streaming, internet speed details, flight data, and mostly the control interface. Well, if I want all these features, then making an Android application is rather efficient. And for doing smart processing, Raspberry Pi gonna be a lot more better than the Arduino family. This is how they will communicate each other. I will use Google Firebase database. I can store video, read or write values in real time. The app will write control interface values to the database, and the Pi will fetch the data from there in low latency. Also, the Pi can send flight data to the app. So firstly, I will set up the Raspberry Pi, then I will make the Android application. As a flight controller, I am using APM 2.8, so it's not necessary that you have to use this particular flight controller, you can use any of them you have. Here's the basic structure of a flight controller. There are some input pins and some output pins. Input pins allows the flight controller to receive signal from the receiver module sent by the transmitter. Then the flight controller calculates the movements with the help of IMU and send the final data to individual motors. And the movement happens. We can't access flight controller's core processor neither the output channel. Otherwise, we won't get the PID corrections. So the best way to go is the receiver inputs. Cause any sorts of errors, the flight controller will correct using the PID corrections. Well, there are lots of procedures to control the flight controller, like accessing the UART port, but all flight controller doesn't offer this function. Basically, I'm manipulating the flight controller with the Raspberry Pi. For the cheaper budget, Pi Zero is awesome. So I installed Raspbian on a SD card and booted the Pi up. Then I opened the IDE, but I'm beginner with the Raspberry Pi, so I got most tutorials on Python, but I'm familiar with C. Okay, it won't be that difficult. I read documentations, but still I'm not quite handy with the Python, but I tried. Then I opened its Python IDE and started coding by adding the Python based library of Firebase called Firebase. I created loops for fetching the Firebase data and included the internet speed test part and forwarded the speed details to the Firebase. Then I measured the loop speed and printed it. I got 24 second loop time. Having more research on Python, I got two awesome things, multiprocessing and multithreading. I won't explain those. You can have a Google search for that, there are tons of information about that. Using these two methods, I can efficiently run multiple programs. Then I bought the Pi camera and attached to it. I installed Motion for streaming the live video, started the server and got the IP address along with the port. But it's limited inside the internet. To access it globally, I have to use port forwarding method. I used this router to connect the Pi with the internet, so I opened this web page and configured the port forwarding. Now I can stream anywhere with the stream link. Now move to the app. I opened Android Studio and Java. Well, I have to. I made the design first, then moved to the main activity. Then I added the button, spinner, sigbar, video view, joystick and created on-click listener for each of them. Then I registered to Google Firebase database and created the database hierarchy accordingly. Finally forwarded the values to the database, then tested the communication. Here's something confused too much viewers. Let me clear it. The phone is connected to the Firebase through the internet, and the drone also connected to the Firebase through the Raspberry Pi, then through the router. So here internet bridges the gap, and for that you can control it from anywhere of the world where internet connection is available. Now move to the smart process and have some attractive designs. I properly constrained all and added few drawable images to get the drone flight data and status. Then I added a test view to show warnings. The Raspberry Pi gathering all the data will get faults and update to database. For example, if the internet speed is slow, then it will show there. Another one, if the Pi takes too much time for executing a loop, then it will also inform there. Well, I have established communication with the Raspberry Pi. Now all I have to do is connecting the Pi with the flight controller. As I said, I'm gonna use input channels and I connected 6 GPIO pins with the input channels of the flight controller. Now I defined those 6 GPIO pins and set them for PWM and mapped the database values to PWM duty cycle. Then I placed all parts properly on the drone and did the radio calibration. Now I set the Python script to run at boot up and that's it. Thank you. I got everything working fine except the lab stream. I checked the port forwarding and it worked fine when I connected the VLC network stream in my laptop. So clearly the fault was in the Android application's code. And then it was solved. Initiate takeoff and change the mode to loiter and control it using the joysticks.
Thousand years later.
This system is not fully accurate. As always, there's a lot of limitations, like it doesn't provide direct control and the streaming latency is not that good. Also, the Raspberry Pi is host in generating PWM signals, means the PWM value is very fluctuating. Well, let's end this series here. Now I'll update obstacle avoidance system and later I'll be making my own flight controller, so keep supporting and till the next video, bye bye.